subscribers and viewers of Obi channel, welcome back again. So in this video, what I'm going to do is to complement a video I did some few days ago, how to monitor your networks with Mikrotik router board. Okay, I did said quite number of things, but addition to the video I did. Okay, so the first tool or the first feature to talk about is the ARP list. With regards to ARP list, what it does is to make you aware of all connected devices on your Mikrotik router board. So in this case, it gives you the IP address of the device. It tells you whether the device is on DHCP mode or static mode. It gives you the device's MAC address and also gives you the interface the device is connecting through. So if we have a list of them, example, let me try and connect my phone to this network and you see it listed here. I'm trying to connect to my network. Okay, it will be okay. So this is my phone connected now. So as you can see, it has been listed as part of the devices on this host. If I disconnect, I think it will take me off, or it will still be recorded down there. Okay, so this is it with ARP list. The second one to talk about is the traffic accounting. This is a traffic accounting. Before you initiate the traffic accounting, you need to enable the account, enable accounting, and also enable account local traffic. You need to apply, you can give it any threshold you want. So let's say I want to give a threshold of 256. You apply and okay. Okay, and then when you're done, you can take a snapshot of the web sites you are visiting. Before you can take a snapshot, you actually need to enable these two features here for you to be able to take the shot. So I've taken a snapshot of my traffic, and it's able to tell me into details where all these IPs. So as you can see, these are the source IP addresses. These are the source IP addresses, meaning addresses coming from outside your router board or your network, which could be the internet. And this is the destination IP address, which is your internal network. Okay, and these are the packets and the byte that is being exchanged between these two IPs. So that is it with traffic accounting snapshot or traffic accounting. So this is the second tool you can use to monitor your network and actually, you know, go ahead and do your filtering or whatever you want to do with it. So that's it with traffic accounting. The next one to talk about is touch. What that touch does is also to kind of packet sniff your interface, any interface you decide to be spied on or be touched. You can just identify it here. So in this case, I want to monitor the activities on the traffic on my one interface, which is port 1. So I enable the MAC address, the port, and then the protocol. These are options, okay? And then you start. So it will start capturing. Let me try and go to certain places and let me see what will happen. Okay. So as you can see, it's able to capture my browsing history. It's able to capture the traffic that goes through my network. I mean, goes through this particular interface. So this is it. So if I want to investigate a particular IP, maybe an IP coming outside from my network, I can simply do this and then get hold of the IP, the port, and then go ahead and do whatever I want to do with it. Okay, so that's the touch. Here you can decide to choose any interface you want. You think, you suspect something not going on well, you can just choose any interface at all and it will work for you. So that is it with touch. The last but one I want to talk about is packet sniffer settings. Packet sniffer settings. Now, before you go ahead and enable packet sniffer settings, you need to enable certain things on it. And for you to have in-depth knowledge of what I'm about to talk with regards to packet sniffer settings, I need to open the new terminal, the terminal mode, I mean the command line mode, and then that is where you can really understand what I'm about to do right now. Okay, I've opened it up. Now let me go ahead and so if you have any streaming server line anywhere, you can decide to enable it and then you specify the IP here and then the port, and then you go ahead. Maybe you can filter the stream or you can just leave it at default. And then now you need to choose the interface you want to sniff on. Okay, so in this case I want to sniff on my one interface. That with the direction, do you want to sniff on the downloads coming in or the bytes you are receiving, or do you want to spy on the bytes you are sending out? In this case I'm saying all directions. Okay, and then applying. Okay, but before you proceed with okay, you need to start the service. So I've started the service and okay, and then you come into your command line mode, and then you can go ahead and see for details what you want to see. So sniffer connection print. Okay, good. Or you can go ahead and do connected print follow, so it will continue to print out. Okay, so at this moment I'm sniffing on ether 1. Okay, I'm sniffing on ether 1 and I'm able to see the IP address is communicating outside your network. You're able to see the protocol is using. That's the source address. With the destination address, you're able to see the IP it's communicating to internal, the port it's using, and the bytes it's exchanging between these two IP addresses. Okay, so that is it with packet sniffer, and that is the last tool I'm talking about. Okay, so these are some of the various means you can actually further protect your router board and other host or servers on your network with this simple but intuitive features Mikrotik has embedded into their routers. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please watch this space and please share my videos, like and please subscribe for more videos on Mikrotik router board and other technologies and their solutions for our daily problems. Thank you very much for watching.
Only righteousness shall bless, but they can do it out of the United States. Who say that right?